Hello, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. I didn't do too much in between, but I did, do a little bit of, grinding, like, stuff that might be, like, grinding. I think it might be, like, a level or two that I went up. But I did run into that dire foe that I died horribly to before. I didn't get on recording, obviously, because I wasn't doing it while I was recording. But I did beat it. Level 61, now that I actually checked its, level. Last time we killed some guys. Robbie's not feeling too great about that. Not sure where this is gonna go from here.
First mate, there's trouble. We got an emergency message from Port Zexen. A ship carrying dozens of exorcists just set sail for Titania.
Oh, cool.
They have orders to eliminate the Lord of Calamity.
Yeesh. Looks like the hideout's not so hidden after all.
Shocking.
It wasn't me. I didn't tell them anything.
Then you won't have any problem helping us. We're rescuing the Therians.
Of course not. I won't let them take Kamoana again.
Wait. That information came from the Bloodwings?
No. From a peddler I often do business with.
Exorcist operations like this are usually kept a closely guarded secret. And you're telling me a regular civilian knew about it?
You think it's a trap?
Trap or not, we don't have a choice.
Our enemies know the odds. If they've set a trap for us, that means they think they can win.
The Armadas!
Yes, they're likely to throw armatized exorcists at us.
Even your demon arm can't eat Armati. You might just have a real problem on your hands.
If I can't devour them, then we kill them.
Yeah, if we overcome the Armati, we can win.
Like with Oscar. But his Armatus was still incomplete.
From what I could gather, if the Exorcist remains armatized for too long, their Moloch will turn into a dragon. But to prevent these dragons from running wild, Melchior embedded a self-destruction art in both Exorcist and Moloch.
You know way too much.
To think they would go that far.
This is all just conjecture, of course, but we should prepare ourselves as best we can. Just make sure not to leave any regrets behind.
Doesn't sound like conjecture at all. God damn, I'm right, aren't I? Obviously, she has the connection to Melchior. I guess, they made that obvious.
I really can't fathom what the Abbey is doing.
Even if they did let us know on purpose, why would they leave us be? I would have expected them to press the attack against us.
Even if their aim is to capture our allies as some kind of leverage against us, their plan is too many holes.
What if we decided to abandon Kamoana and the others? They'd be no closer to capturing Velvet.
Do they actually want the Therians back?
What are you saying?
Why did Melchior place that illusion on a ball to lure Velvet in?
That was so he could capture her, right?
And in case he couldn't capture her, he could kill her and create another Therian.
Okay, so if securing the Therians is so important to them, why would they throw Orthrus to the winds?
That's a puzzler. Melchior was right there, and he didn't try to protect Orthrus at all.
I don't understand it.
Good question.
It's like they're toying with us.
I don't see any point in that either. They must know we won't give up.
Actually, that could be close to the mark. What if they're just trying to rattle us? Everything would fit, including the assault on Titania.
Whatever's going on, I don't think we're going to like it.
Armati. I think they just brought up that name. Okay. I'm gonna assume it's something from Zestiria then. If they're bringing it up so casually as a name.
So, Eleanor, about that Armatus Oscar used, was that something the Abbey has been working on for a while?
I was never involved in weapons development or anything like that. But I did hear of a secret research division. Word was that they were deciphering ancient scrolls and books coming from every corner of the Empire. Apparently, Teresa knew something of the ancient tongue, and they called her in to help from time to time.
Did she work on Enominat's book?
I was never privy to any of the details, but I think the books were mostly about controlling Malachim.
Well, that Siegfried thing of Zavid's is some kind of power control device, right?
The Abbey probably learned about Siegfried in one of those books. and realized they could use it to armatize.
So Melchior tracked Savid down and stole the formula. Makes sense.
It was all so they could create the Armatus.
Will Ifrid be all right?
Complete or not, they've seen that they can use the Armatus in battle. They have no use for him anymore.
Let's get back to Titania, Aizen. I'll help out with the ship.
Right. Let's set sail.
Yeah, there's not much choice left other than to head back. My best guess at this point is that what Velvet and them are doing is helping them somehow. Peak malevolence. It's such a vague terminology. I would not be surprised if removing them would be part of it. But they don't need Velvet to do that. Or maybe it's somehow you add the Therians in there in order to build up faith in Anominat, and then you set up Velvet as basically a fall person in order to keep the faith in Anominat, keep him strong, while also at the same time achieving the peak malevolence that would be without the Therians' intervention. So you set it up, then you let her go. Maybe. It doesn't seem like Arthur wanted that to be. So maybe that's a new plan? Maybe.
It's an urgent message! Let him know that they'll be arriving at Titania within a few hours!
God,
so it was you all along, Bien Phu.
Miss Mogilu!
I'm surprised I didn't sense it. There is a Gesh on you, interfering with our pact. Well played, Melchior. Impressive. That old man must have planned all of this, from the very moment you escaped me. Even my imprisonment in Titania and my encounter with Velvet. All calculated down to the minute. Nice.
Forgive me, Miss Mogilu! There was no way I could fight against Lord Melchior's arts!
I don't care. I don't care about anything. And I don't care that I don't.
What an interesting... Oh, did we hear all this? No, kill the bird! Fuck.
Oh no! You've caught me red-handed! I've been in league with the Abbey this whole time!
That's not true! I'm the one you want!
We were listening. We heard it all.
Oh, boring.
How convenient.
Fine then. Do with us what you will.
It's not like I trusted you to begin with. Spy or no spy, this was inevitable. Besides, you're not sorry. Make yourself useful and fight for us.
You're good at this cruelty that's also compassion thing, aren't you?
I just don't have the time to deal with you two. After this whole business is over with, I'll devour you, if that's what you want.
Hey, Velvet. Tell me, what does it feel like to... hate? Does it torment you? Is it agony? Does the searing fire of your hatred empower you to feel? Does it give your life meaning where there was none?
Land ho! Titania! There's an Abbey ship in the front docks!
Take us around!
Didn't he say
back.
A few hours? Ah, well,
if
whatever.
If you want your answer, fight by my side. You'll see it the very moment I kill Artorias.
In the face of doom, still the crow caws defiantly. You really know how to vex me.
Well, at least Doggy Doo wasn't the traitor when it comes down to it. Are these the docks I escaped from the first? Maybe.
So, You're using the forbidden arts. This has to be Melchior's doing.
We got that right.
Stop! I'm the one you want!
The Lord of Calamity.
That again? What a melodramatic name.
It's what you're called by the scores of citizens whose lives you've ruined. Face the enormity of your sins.
What idiocy.
We'll carve the weight of your sin from your flesh. We are the wings of the divine will.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't even know you could skip these. I was just preparing to look at their weaknesses.
They are madness.
As expected.
Interesting. They get new weapons and stuff? Okay. Okay. They have very different ones. So weak sauce. Oh my goodness.
Them. I have to kill.
What is wrong with her? Is this the illusion? Messing with her mind? I don't know. I'm still on that theory. Oh no, not dragons.
So this is it.
They destroyed themselves.
Just as I expected.
The Abbey. They know exactly what they're doing.
Grimoire, where are the Therians? Couldn't tell you. They came out of nowhere, and before I knew it, we were all split up.
How's the book?
Nearly done, but I'm still working on the critical passages at the very end.
All of you, get on board the Von Eltia. I'll find the Therians.
Oh? You really think we can make it past a horde of armatized exorcists?
Stay behind. I don't care.
Don't touch that!
You don't have to do this alone. We're all in this together. And I promise. I promise I'll protect you, Velvet.
You'll protect me. Long ago, Luffy said the same thing. But that sort of idealistic drivel will kill you. Make your worthless promises. They won't change reality. Look what happened to Luffy. Dead. Murdered. And I couldn't protect him either. In the end, no matter how much he cared for me, my only brother, his life torn away from him. Oh, it must have hurt.
Velvet.
You worry about yourself, Lafayette. That's an order.
An order.
We have to keep Enominat out of the picture, so that I can kill Artorias.
Let's go. I was just wondering, am I really by myself?
We'll push the enemy back and keep an eye out for the Therians.
Yeah, she's becoming much less stable.
Curse you, Abby! This place was finally starting to feel like a hideout.
I hate to say it, but we can't beat the exorcists. All we can do now is protect this harbor with our very lives.
Aye, let's do it. We'll guard your back, Aizen. So don't worry about us. Go give those exorcist dirtbags a big old beatdown!
You got it. I'm counting on you to protect the docks.
Okay. It's important to protect the docks, but shouldn't we do something to stop everyone else from, shouldn't we do something to stop, them from escaping with potentially some of the Therians, right? Feel as though that would be sort of important. Maybe cut them off some suppressing fire on the other docks in order to stop their ship from going, or maybe we could destroy their ship too. Then again, if we did that, they might get bored out and they might have an overreaction and go out of their way to kill the Therians instead of capturing them, which seems like a decent chance. Again, this seems like it's a trap. Precisely how it's a trap, outside of the armatized,
I know this
exorcist.
Isn't the best time, but I have something to say. Please forgive me. I've been a spy for Lord Melchior.
You were the one telling the Abbey about us?
Yes, I'm so sorry.
Melchior is a clever one, isn't he? Planting his spy right next to Magilu. After all, a forest is the best place to hide a tree.
Melchior used his arts to place orders on Bienfu that overrode Mogilu's pact.
That son of a dog.
Please
dog?
Don't hate me.
I meant Melchior, not you.
Really? Exerting control over someone else's life goes against everything Aizen stands for. We know you were forced to do it against your will.
But my spying put everyone in serious danger. That's still a fact.
The Bloodwings also knew what we were up to. The Abbey would have figured it out with or without you. What'd you tell them anyway?
That Velvet is actually pretty good wife material. And what fishing rods Aizen prefers. And what Miss Mogilu says in her sleep. And how fast Dial's tail regrows.
What?
What? That's what you told them?
It's done. Pay it no more heed. But things must be set aright.
Aright? How?
Eleanor, I apologize for suspecting you. I'm sorry.
Aizen?
That's right! I must apologize as well! I'm deeply sorry, Lady Eleanor.
Very well. Apologies accepted all around.
Did they expect Eleanor to join us at some point? Or did he just expect Magilu to, capture Bienfu back? I wonder if he obviously has planned out this a bit in some way. And it was before the throne, so...
Are exorcists using armatization aware that it could cost them their lives?
I'm sure they are. If I were still with the Abbey, I would likely be using an armatus too. Endangering one's own life in order to save the many? It's the logical choice. But using something that dangerous so frequently in battle is absolutely wrong.
The Abbey must be starting to feel the pressure too.
Even so, the losses are unacceptably high.
That's how badly they want the Therians, and how big a threat we represent. Or it could be that it has nothing to do with us, and the real point is to test their new weapon.
That can't be. It's all an experiment?
A blade proves its true worth by making it through battle unbroken. Are exorcists all that different?
Your logic is sound, but it's still awful.
We were able to survive this time, but it won't be much longer until they've perfected the armatization.
That's not the only thing we need to worry about where ticking clocks are concerned. Am I wrong?
Velvet.
It doesn't matter. We kill whoever gets in our way.
Everything's getting all muddled. Maybe that's what's getting to her the most. Not just her own regrets, but... it's really unsure if what we're doing is even going to achieve what we want it to.
Woo! It's a prize!
Holy shit! Fighting these guys! They just stun so motherfucking easily! And they're really fucking good at grouping up on people!
First they rob the Malachim of their will, and now their bodies too. Makes me sick.
But still, it fits their reason. They want strength, and no art can squeeze strength from a Moloch like that one.
True. So that's technically what it is. It's a fusion where they're stealing their bodies by force in a way. Honestly, the only real... I'm having a little bit of issues with these guys, but... outside of them, I'm like, I destroy like every battle of our boss battles, like, relatively easily. These might just be a little bit of a learning curve in terms of their different styles of fighting.
I can see why someone would gamble his life to wield it.
They're dying. All of them. Mere tools.
Even the people are becoming tools, eh? Okay, you guys are alive still. That's good.
So, you all got away.
It was all I could do to flee. I have lost face.
You don't have a face!
I was so scared!
It's okay now, dear. I won't let them cause you any more pain.
Medissa was the one who saved us.
Thank you.
I could never forgive them for involving children. That's all. Kurogane, head to the rear docks. Keep them safe. If you find the prince and Griffin, take the Von Altia and escape.
As you wish. Rokuro, take the Storm Quell. I made it with the Orichalcum you gave me.
You actually did it.
I abandoned all desire and forged it with a clear mind. You will find no harder sword in all the world.
Stormquill. Cool. Made from Orichalcum. I'll use it well, Kurogane.
Good. Nice. I assume I can... Spirit daggers. Where's the Kurogane ones?
It's complete! The Orichalcum Blade, Stormquell!
It's the hardest blade the world has ever known.
Even to an untrained eye, that sword is obviously something special.
Kurogane is a real master! Color me amazed!
The Godblade Storm Howl versus the Orichalcum Storm Quell. This will be something to see.
Will it end in triumph, or will you need to try more oomph? The gods alone know.
The gods have nothing to do with it. Skill alone will determine who lives and who dies.
Yep, even playing ground, that means... It's a good sign. Did I really not get anything? Them's the prince. Hello, Prince of Boy.
Managed to avoid capture, huh, Prince?
As did you. You did well to avoid Artorias and his forces.
Lord Artorias is here?
He is. I overheard some exorcists mention
Ooh.
It.
Artorias.
If you want to die, do it alone. We're saving the Therians before anything else.
Besides, we're so close to deciphering the ancient book.
I know. We'll escape from the rear docks. Follow me.
Watch out, Princey Wincy. You ain't no Therian. If Griffin gets there first, we're leaving you behind.
Understood.
Yeah, priorities are straight. Is that all of them? I'm trying to remember if there's any other... If there's any other ones I should be concerned about. Ooh, oh, right. Oh, there's a co-red. Okay, let's try it.
Are we ready for this?
Level 16. And...
Water.
Okay. Yeah, I did not get that off at a good time this time. Oh well. Oh, there's the strong one. There you go. I was so close to just being able to defeat that really easily. At least they don't give any XP, so I didn't lose anything from having everyone dead there. I was so close to being able to beat it. I was just trying to get off a final mystic art, and I would have been able to take it down, and then I lost control of it, and then it started using its arts that just destroy everyone, and I let it use it even though I didn't really need to let it use it at all, or any of that. Okay. Allows the ability to add up the three random skills to equipment on hard mode or higher. Cool. Well, it's dead now, so that's good. Oh, here we go. Have I not been able to come here before? I don't know if that's new or not, or if I just missed it previously. Angel wings. Yeah, that's... interesting one.
Will Artorias use an Armatus as well?
I don't know.
It's hard to believe that the Abbey's leader would risk using an art that could end his own life, but...
The Shepherd's reputation would be ruined if he self-destructed over some botched formula. On the other hand, if the risk is based on the user's ability, then the Legates might not have any trouble.
So if Artorias were to try, he'd armatize with Innominaut.
Can an Empyrean be used as an Armatus? I'm not even sure Artorias can handle that.
He'll do it. Why else would he try to revive Innominaut?
But we're talking about an Empyrean!
He'll succeed. I'm certain of it. This is the Shepherd Artorias we're talking about here. Whether God or Devil stands in his way, he won't be swayed. That's who he is.
Velvet!
But it won't save him. He'll die by my hand. Empyrean or no Empyrean.
She has so much faith in him, I swear.
Eisen, there's trouble. The enemy found the Von Eltia.
And?
Several enemy ships are heading this way right now.
Set sail!
Fuck.
Now!
I'm not. No, that's stupid.
I'm, glad we were able to save everyone.
Don't do it.
There's no escape, Lord of Calamity.
Benwick, forget me. Take the Von Eltia and leave. Now!
No!
That's madness. What do you think you're doing?
If I don't take them down, they'll sink you from afar.
How about we all...
Raise anchor! We'll make it through somehow.
Oh, even Doggy Doo's
participating. You hear me?
Crazy kids.
We're not going to die. We're going to kill.
Kill or be killed, I suppose we can get down to it.
What do we do now?
We'll head to the front docks.
To steal an Abbey ship, I take it.
That's where the Abbey's main forces will be concentrated. And Lord Artorias should be there too.
Did we really take that long?
But we still don't have a way to fight Innominaut.
Can he summon Innominaut here?
I told you, if you want to die, do it alone.
I'm not asking you to come with me.
Use me.
Oh.
Percival.
Don't worry. Griffin got away. If you use me as a hostage, you should be able to steal a ship.
I owe you one for this. But don't expect gratitude.
I don't.
Looks like this is our best and only bet.
I mean, could the Von Eltia really not have just stuck around for a little itty bit longer? I feel like they probably could have stuck around for a little itty bit longer.
We're going to the front docks to escape. Don't forget that.
I know. Arthur's first maxim, right?
I forget what that is. And I know what the maxims are, I forget what his first one is. Never let your guard down or something like that.
I'm worried.
About this whole hostage thing, you mean?
Yeah, that too. But Velvet's acting really strange.
And that's unusual how?
Moggy Lou!
Yelling at me won't change anything. Her thirst for blood knows no bounds, and she's got all the self-control of a wounded beast. With the way she's acting, I'm not sure she'll be able to escape.
She's cut her way through all her problems before. She can do it again.
I hope so. But everything has its limits. There's no blade that will not break. Nor is there such a heart. When the time comes, you'll need to make a decision. It's best you start figuring it out now.
When the time comes...
Well, there's always going to be a choice when you're dealing with stuff like this, so...
Phew. Well, looks like we shook off our pursuit.
Of course we did. This is the Von Eltia.
No, it can't be. This is terrible. Turn back, now!
What? There's no way we can do that!
I finally deciphered the last part of the book. If what it says is true, then you know me not is already!
Yay! We were helping all along. I'm not shocked. I'm not shocked in the slightest.
The coast is clear!
Alright, let's make a break for the docks.
You're running.
Let's continue running. Come on.
It's Lord Artorias, and...
No!
No, stop!
Please, now's the time to negotiate for safe passage.
Step back, Your Highness. The girl before you wants nothing other than to kill me.
You better believe it!
This is a trap. We're leaving.
Let me go! I have to save her!
That ain't gonna happen, kid. Don't forget, you're my ticket out of here, too.
I'm not your tool! Try to stop me and I'll take you down! Even you, Aizen.
Who?
Your Armatus isn't gonna stop me!
Don't worry. I have another trick up my sleeve.
That sword. Is that a Recalcum? Good job, little bro. Never seen that before.
Damn right! The hardest sword there is!
It may be made of Recalcum. But still...
What is that?
It's time. Stand down, Shiki.
Don't be a spoil sport. I'm just starting to have fun.
Get caught in the middle of this, and even you won't survive unscathed. The one to face Velvet will be a Nomenaut.
What? That still looks from...
What?
Nope, never mind. Oh, that's...
Hello, sister. Did you miss me?
Luffy! Velvet's brother?
So that's his game. That's right. I am Lafayette Crow. And more.
Bullshit.
I am also Empyrean Innominat, the Suppressor.
Bullshit.
No. That's... Innominat?
If you're gonna do this, you gotta commit. He's our enemy.
I know! This is just another illusion! I'll devour all of you!
Level 78, okay. I'm thinking maybe I won't be able to win this one. Fire.
Okay. That's what you've been doing this whole time. Struggling against all reason.
Shut up! Don't you dare! Pretend to be-
Fuck. Fuck. Oh, almost dead already.
My brother!
Nope. Well, let's see if I need to win this.
Your struggles are over. All your pain, your suffering, I'll end all of it for you.
Oh, no, I did not.
Is this the power of an Empyrean? Exactly. This boy is Empyrean in Nominat the Suppressor.
How much do people know? God damn it.
I took away his strength!
By kidnapping the Therians? Sorry to burst your bubble, but you were a wee bit late. It was never about the amount of malevolence the Therians devoured. What we needed to awaken him
was 8 different types. Greed, conceit, lust, cowardice, selfishness, obsession. Those 6 Enomenon had already obtained by the time you managed to tear the Therians away. That leaves just the 2 that Velvet carries inside her. Once Enomenon has them, he will fully awaken.
And I don't even need an Earth Pulse for that. I can eat them right here.
Like hell you will!
God,
if
no!
If you're that weak, stay out of my way. Ow.
It's all an illusion.
That hurts, Velvet.
Shut up! Shut up!
Are you going to kill me, sister?
No way! No way! Go away!
Velvet, it was always so hard for me. I was so frail. All I did was cause you trouble. Is that why? Is that why you wanted me to go away?
This is clearly planned out by Arthur. No! Don't!
I never wanted you to go. I wanted you to live. I wanted you to be by my side. But in the end, I couldn't protect you. All I could do was offend you. To get my vengeance, I devoured. I killed.
Of course you did.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Luffy. It hurt, didn't it? Fee! Kill him, please!
But please?
It's Luffy said! He's my brother!
But Velvet, I never wanted you to avenge me. I mean, it's that sort of selfish emotion that creates malevolence, that creates the demons.
What?
That's why I'm going to help Arthur. We're going to make all the pain in the world go away. Including that hate, that ugly malevolence in you.
Ugly malevolence?
The awakened Enomenon will suppress all negative emotions. He will remake humanity into beings free from sin.
That's bullshit.
You take away all their sins, and people aren't people anymore!
I think that's just what they intend. Like how they steal free will from the Malachim.
It will be a peaceful world, free from pain.
Yeah, with no point to it.
So your goal this whole time was to rob people of their free will?
If even an exorcist like you can let your emotions tempt you to betrayal, clearly, it is the only way.
I'll make this world a safe place free from demons. That has always been my dream. Don't worry. My wounds will heal. Once I have eaten you, sister.
What's going on? This is bad! We'll be swallowed alive!
Wait. I always... Everything I did for you... How could you do this to...
Thank you. It's because of what you've done that I need to make amends. You've hurt so many people, and all for nothing.
There's no reason. There's no way this isn't an illusion.
Unfortunate.
But they're within me now. I'll find them.
A weapon can't just be hard, you know. It's gotta be flexible, too. Or it'll snap.
If you're addressing me, do you care to test that out?
Nah. I think I'll wait on that. At least until you and Innominat finish up your armatization.
Knew it.
Shepherd Artorias! What have you done?
It's all according to my plan, Your Highness. Let us return to the capital.
Is this another Earth Pulse? Oh, we're inside Innominat.
What just happened?
Good question.
We were eaten by an Earth Pulse.
This happened to you before, didn't it?
It's different this time. It looks like our awakened friend Innominat is using the land as his vessel. In other words, this Earth Pulse is now part of his body. I was able to flee him only because I found a rift in the Earth Pulse as it formed.
So, Velvet and the others?
I guess I won my bet. Took long enough.
Bravo! You do have a talent, if nothing else.
Oh, Melchior. If you're here, this place must be more important than I suspected.
Move aside. I must close this Earth Pulse rift.
Bienfu, protect the rift! Do well, and I'll forgive that little betrayal of yours. But if you run, my curse will follow you for eternity!
Bien! You got it!
It looks like I just won my bet. If I let you seal this rift now, I'll never collect. Illusions won't work on me. You can't break a heart that's already broken.
That day, I interrupted my art when your heart broke. I suppose I was taking pity upon my student. But this time, know that I won't hold back. I will grind your heart into dust!
God, so much is happening.
You're awake. I'm glad to see you're okay. It looks like we got sucked into the Earth Pulse.
Are you all right, Eleanor? What about everyone else?
I'm fine. But...
Kill. I killed so many. Murdered. Slaughtered. It was all for him. I killed for him. But he said I was ugly. Nothing. Nothing. All for nothing. I can't. I have to kill. Die. Die.
The whole time, she...
You're awake. Come on, we're leaving. I have to kill them.
But he know me not as your...
It's just an illusion! A fake! A trick! Or, what if it was really him? Then that means he betrayed me, doesn't it? You think I can't kill a traitor like him? Why? Why wouldn't I? Just how many do you think I've killed? You, who watched me do it!
I'm... sorry.
Velvet!
Luffy, time to wake up.
Oh, they're doing... Oh my goodness, it's obvious.
I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good.
Enomi-not!
A bit of a fever, I'm afraid.
No, this is
at
different.
Least the new medicine's supposed to come today.
A vision of the past?
Until then, you stay in bed.
See? I killed him! It was easy! I'm used to it by now. Alright, we're getting out of here! With your power!
But...
Now!
We've gotta find Aizen and the rest.
I said now! Enough! Stop it! They're the ones who need to be stopped! Isn't that right? I'll kill them! I'll kill them all!
You must calm down.
Fine. I'll calm down and look for an exit. That's what you want, right?
Does she only have two gears now? Fuck. If that is Luffy, then Artorias did something fucked up to him.
Whatever the case, we have to get out of here. Let's keep moving for now.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yep.
Are you all right, Luffy said?
Yeah, I am. But I'm worried about Velvet.
This may be more than he can bear. Not that I blame him. Luffy said, perhaps you should rest within me for a while.
No.
But if you don't, then...
I know. But if I hide, it'll only hurt Velvet even more. I should at least be at her side.
You really have become stronger.
But I haven't. I hate it. But there's nothing I can do to help Velvet now.
Of course there is. Having someone nearby can be all the help you need sometimes. Like when I lost my mother.
Eleanor...
So, let's keep an eye on Velvet while we search for the others, all right? Just remember that I'm always with you, Luffy said.
I know. Thank you.
Obviously, we need to stop Arthur from taking everyone's free will away. That is something we need to do. The matter of whether that's actually Luffy or not doesn't actually matter that much. Well, at least not at the moment. Ooh, okay. Our spirits
here. We will
here.
Need to be extremely
Stop.
Wary.
We need to fight. More of these. Yeah, it seems relatively straightforward though, so let's keep going. Oh, hey, Kirigane. What are you doing here, Kirigane?
The boy who called himself Enomi-not. Could he really be Velvet's younger brother?
It could have been an illusion intended to torment her. Don't you agree, Eleanor?
I do. Velvet's objective is avenging her brother, after all. We've all seen how strongly she feels about it. I find it hard to believe that the one so dear to her is still alive.
I don't know what powers Enominat possesses, but I think that really was her little brother. Velvet was able to see past Melchior's illusions. But look at her now. I just don't want to believe that the real Lafi could do such a thing.
Could it be possible that Enominat was reborn into her brother's body?
I don't know. But if that was the case, I'm not sure Velvet would be in so much agony.
Yes, I guess. Enominat actually being Velvet's brother. It makes a twisted sort of sense. But it's too awful.
I mean, he did seem, at the time, willing to go through with Artorias' stuff. And he was part of the ritual that made everything happen. But at least I get the impression that at the very beginning of the game, when the demons were made visible to everyone, the same basic ritual went on with her sister.
I don't think we
Does
have
her
a
sister
chance.
Exist in some sort of form? I don't know. It doesn't seem like that makes sense at the moment. Is that being done on purpose? It has to be.
Look!
Hey, stay with me. I'll get someone right away.
It's okay. I'm tired.
Have you been journeying long, then?
He has emotion in his voice.
10 years. My master entrusted everything to me. But I couldn't do anything.
10 years?
My wings are weak. It doesn't matter anymore.
I see. If you've been working that hard, you surely need a break. I just happened to get my hands on some prickle boar meat. I'll be cooking up a stew for dinner. But would you care to join me?
Huh? No way.
All I have on me now is this apple. Here. Once your belly is full of warm food, you'll be able to pick yourself back up. I can feel it. Your body is shouting, "I want to live."
I'm a disgrace. I don't deserve to live.
Is life something you have to earn? To deserve?
Well,
these feelings are natural. You eat when you're hungry and cry when you're sad. Feeling these things is proof that we're alive.
Alive?
What's your name? Mine is Celica. Celica Crow.
This doesn't help, Arthur, showing me this.
I'm an exorcist. Artoria. No, Arthur. I'm Arthur.
Oh, he made it up. Okay.
Artorias!
What in the world was that?
Rokuro! Aizen!
You saw it too then?
Sure did. Artorias. And he called himself Arthur.
I've heard of this. The Earth in Historia. They say that events on the world's surface cast imprints on the Earth pulse that runs below.
In other words, an illusion of the past.
How convenient we get these then.
It's not an illusion. That was my sister. So, he managed to fool her too, is it? Yes. Yes, that must be it. That's why she freed me from the prison.
Rokuro, have you recovered from your wounds?
Yep. Tough as nails. That's old Rokuro. I'm more worried about Velvet. Is she okay?
How could she be okay? Enominat is reborn, and it's her little brother.
A blade can't just be hard. It's gotta be flexible, or it'll snap the first time it meets an unexpected force. I misunderstood the true meaning of strength, and so did he.
Let's just worry about ourselves for now. This Earth Pulse is completely under Enominat's domain. We can think of it as an extension of his body.
Yeah, which means my power won't get us out of here.
Be wary. Enominat may be the one showing us these memories. Remember, he's after Velvet.
And the two types of malevolence inside her.
True. And we may be able to use that against him to get us out of here.
What are you saying? Just use her?
If it's necessary.
We have to keep moving. Nothing will be gained by staying here. And we ought to look for Magilu. Even she doesn't deserve to be stuck here forever.
She's not. Not that we know that. So, Glimmers, every time... she's mentioned a few times where she's seeing Ceres like she's her sister. Did Artorias tell them that she was to some extent? Is she just being insane in a way? Because I don't recall there being anything to indicate a connection outside of my own personal speculation. I don't think she really started saying anything like that until she started her mental breakdown. Oh, so many questions. You know what? Usually the Tales games are not the best in keeping me questioning what's going to happen. It has its twists and turns and there's things I don't expect and whatnot, but usually, you know where it's going.
So what is this Earthen Historia you mentioned?
As I've said, an Earth Pulse is a natural force that circulates within the land. Wind blows, water flows, birds fly, flowers bloom. All actions in nature leave their mark on the Earth Pulse. These marks become etched within the land itself and remain a part of the Earth Pulse, like memories.
So it's a record of the world's past.
Does it remember human and Moloch deeds?
Everything that occurs is part of nature, including the acts of humans, Molochim, and even demons.
So that means that even this very conversation is being recorded in the Earthen Historia?
Anything bad I've done in secret, any insults you've ever told behind someone's back, the land sees it all.
My insults?
It's just an example. Pay it no mind.
Does that mean that Enominat is drawing specific memories from the Earthen Historia and showing them to Velvet?
I believe so. That's how Rokuro and I saw the same thing, even though we weren't there. With the Earth itself as his vessel, it's a trick only Enominat could pull off.
Awfully devious for a self-styled Empyrean.
But the attack did strike home. Keep a close watch on her until we're out of the Earth Pulse.
Right.
Yeah, I suppose it did create the whole, impression of betrayal even more deeper, driving her. Probably trying to drive her into more of... I wonder, because... Enominat already had obsession. That was the one that really stuck out to me when he was talking about it. And that's the one that I really would associate with Velvet more. I wonder what the two she has are, then. Presumably the last Therian that we devoured, and her normal one.
Velvet's psyche took a heavy blow there.
Yes. She's in rough shape.
How long do you think she'll last?
What do you mean?
Just what I said. Remember, hardness alone won't save you from breaking. If she keeps being shaken up like this, she won't be able to handle it.
But what can we do?
If she breaks, she breaks. Until then, we go on with our mission.
What? Can't we help her?
If you let sympathy fog your vision, you can end up crashed on a reef.
Even so, we can't just let her suffer. It's too much.
I'm fairly sure that Velvet would say the same thing if she was in Aizen's place.
And do you agree, Rokuro?
Me? I still have a debt to Velvet. I will pay it. But in the end, her fate will be something she'll have to decide for herself.
That's true, but...
Then I have a decision of my own to make. I won't give up on Velvet. no matter what.
I see. Do what you have to.
We won't stop you.
Good. I mean, well, you're probably going to get fucked over majorly hard by trying to help her, but I can appreciate that dedication and loyalty. It is very much like a family member.
See this?
Personally, I don't buy the theory that Fee has in terms of why Velvet wouldn't be falling to the illusions, in that she broke them before doesn't mean she can't do it again. The only reason she broke it before was because an inconsistency popped up.
Welcome home, Arthur.
Hi, Celica. I fixed the fence around the house.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. With the brigands stepping up their attacks, the town elders have been worried. But this should put their minds at ease.
No. If the brigands turn into demons, a mere fence won't stop them.
Hmm?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm pretty confident in my carpentry. And the other two?
Probably at the Cape again. I've warned them 100 times that it's dangerous.
Luffy said probably badgered Velvet into going. Don't worry, she'll watch out for him.
Yeah, I can only hope that this little one grows up to be as strong as she is one day.
Huh?
Oh, what a way to tell him.
You're happy, I hope.
He doesn't do emotions.
Of course I am. I never thought I could ever be this happy.
And you don't want any... I mean, suppress negative emotions. Well, really, just suppress negative emotions. The fine line between the black and white of emotion positives and negatives is...
I only wish I'd known earlier. I would have made something even nicer for you.
It's very gray.
Oh, you made this for me?
Yeah. I put all my heart into it.
I'll cherish it always. It'll remind me of this happy day.
Let this serve as proof of our love. This I swear. I swear to protect you both with my life.
Hmm. So what changed?
That's Lord Artorias' past.
Oh, that's rich! You mean you believe that tripe?
It's all a pack of lies. His smile, his promise, everything.
Obviously, they're trying to bait her into... Oh, hello. They're definitely trying to bait her into embracing her hatred.
To think I ate up his lies without questioning a word. What a joke.
What we just saw, was that from before the opening?
Yeah. Celica was there, and Artorias still had use of his arm. It didn't look like he was an exorcist either.
I never would have thought Lord Artorias could smile so tenderly.
But he's since become an exorcist, taking on the mantle of shepherd and the weight of the world.
All because he lost his beloved wife.
I'd understand if you wanted to back out. But at this rate, I think the time is coming. Not much longer now.
It's coming.
Based on the beginning of the game, at the very least, it seemed like... I guess there were demons at the very beginning of the game, and then there was some sort of, we saw demons before the event that seemed to mirror what happened to, Luffy. the one that happened with her sister.
Velvet didn't know those things about Artorias and Celica, did she?
Probably not. That was when the two were alone and first getting to know each other.
We were seeing glimpses of a warm, loving family. But really, it just gave me the creeps.
Same here. I could keenly feel Enominat scheming behind everything we saw.
He's trying to get at Velvet.
I think she used to truly love Lord Artorias. Having that happy past thrust in front of her at a time like this must be tearing her apart.
Probably, but a demon like me wouldn't understand.
What Velvet is going through is horrible. Even as a human, I can scarcely imagine what it must be like. But I approach it, just a little bit, because like her, I was his pupil.
Artorias said he needed two types of malevolence to awaken Enominat. The illusions at a ball, making sure we knew about the attack on Titania, and Enominat appearing as her brother. If all of that was planned to extract the malevolence from her, we'd all better brace for worse to come.
How much... If we're inside Enominat, is it able to absorb the malevolence Velvet gives off? Like, are we at a point where it's just trying to get those emotions out so that it can get them? It can get more malevolence of that type? Oh, great. That sounds...
The Scarlet Knight? This is Velvet's village.
Oh, this is going to be what really happened, eh?
Damn! So many of them! Celica, I'm coming!
It's too late! Take Velvet and Lafayette and run!
I can't do that! I want to have my life with you! With our child!
Arthur!
Celica!
Yeah. I assume that's the jaws of Enominat or some shit. Same thing happened to Velvet. I guess it is reminiscent of the thing that pulled us in this Earth Pulse too. This warn, we saw something that looked like the ritual. It looked like the same thing that happened to Laffy. Maybe I'm remembering it wrong.
Why? Why couldn't I? Why couldn't I protect my own family?
Remember this moment well, Artorias. Humans are weak, filled with sin.
Has this been him the entire time?
Melchior!
The people of this village offered you and your beloved family up to the demon brigands.
The fuck does that mean?
A sacrifice, so that they could escape and hide.
No?
No, they wouldn't.
No one would be so aware that they could do that.
It happens often. The reason people act on is burdened by the weight of their sins. However... I have found a method to adjust their reason.
A domain? What is this incredible power? Don't tell me the Empyrean we've been searching for was here this whole time. These... Molochim...
So they have been reborn, but be not deceived. They are not the same people you knew.
No, Fee?
Why?
What?
Why must fate be so cruel?
It appears that Innominat's resurrection is incomplete. We must guide him until we understand why. I'll be taking these Malakim.
Wait!
Why was Fee born from her sister? Her son! Oh.
I'm sorry I couldn't keep my promise. I'll make things right. I'll abandon who I am. Nameless Moloch, I will forge a pact with you. I will put an end to all the pain in this world.
Do you have it in you? You who abandoned my friend's ideals and fled.
On the souls of my dead master, wife, and child, this I swear. My name is Artorius Colbrand. I have inherited the will and the strength of Claudin Asgard, former head of the Exorcists.
Very well. Let tonight's tragedy change fate and birth salvation.
Moloch, it was me. You don't remember?
Not at all.
They said you were reborn as a Moloch. That means... what exactly?
The soul of a human who passed away can, given the right trigger, be reborn as a Moloch.
You're saying that Artorius's child was reborn as Lafayette?
If what we saw was real, yes.
Who?
So the female Moloch that was born along with him was...
my sister's reincarnation. But I ate her long ago.
You didn't know, right?
I knew. I had already caught on to who Ceres really was.
Velvet.
But it doesn't matter. What does it change? I'll devour anything to fulfill my goal. My sister. My brother. Even the world. That's who I am. That's all I am.
That was the day all of this started, wasn't it?
Yeah, the opening. Innominat was halfway revived and demons became visible to all.
His power also robbed almost every Moloch of their free will that day.
I never imagined that Lord Artorius's quest to change the world was so steeped in tragedy. The villagers should have never sold them out to those bandits.
It was cruel, yes, but nothing remarkable. People are capable of anything when under pressure. Even more so when they can do it under the mantle of the greater good.
I suppose.
Velvet's family was probably the furthest outside the village circle that night.
That's pure selfishness.
Humans are selfish creatures. You should be aware of that by now. That's why you said what you said just now, even if you didn't know it. Artorius's quest to change the world, not Artorius's quest to save humanity.
I
mean no disrespect. It's just an observation.
A man with the power to change the world turned his back on the potential of humanity. That may be the biggest tragedy of that night.
The savior of the world. Lost all hope in its people.
It's Melchior's fault. At least it seems that way. He's the real enemy here, it seems. You know, I should probably stop at this point, but... nah.
Aizen, you said a human soul can be reborn as a Moloch given the right trigger, right? Is that something that happens frequently?
I'm afraid I don't have an answer for that. We know that humans are sometimes reborn as Malakim, but not how or why. It's more likely among people with greater resonance, but the process is still a mystery.
Huh. So it's not something that happens, or that can be made to happen, easily. Ordinarily, at least.
But Velvet's sister was reborn as Ceres, and her unborn child came back as Lafayette. What are the chances of that?
It might not have been chance. They both died on the Scarlet Night. Their rebirths may have been influenced by the sacrificial ceremony.
Same as Lafayette.
Are you saying that Ignominot made it happen on purpose?
Call it an educated guess. But I don't think even an Empyrean can control the lives of humans or Malakim at his whim.
If it wasn't chance, it might have been destiny.
Velvet said she ate Ceres. Her own sister reborn as a Moloch. How could such a horrible thing be destiny?
Sorry. I didn't mean to make light of a tragedy, but our fates intertwine, the good and the bad, whether we like it or not. That's what makes it destiny, right?
True. But this...
Get a hold of yourself, Eleanor. Velvet and Lafayette are in rougher waters than any of us. They'll be looking to you to light their way.
Yes. I must remain calm and steady.
Whew. So much need to be calm, three soul bottles. Okay, that's a great sign about what's about to happen. I mean, sometimes you just have to... God, I'm not a psychologist. I'm not that good at all of it. Oh, there's our exit.
Look, over there!
An Earth Pulse Rift. We may be able to get out from there.
No. God, one more.
Arthur, there's something I'd like to speak to you about. Alone.
Oh no.
Two souls possessing powerful resonance and free of malevolence. These must be sacrificed on the Scarlet Night.
Ah, yes. The ceremony to resurrect Ignominot. You read my book.
I haven't fully mastered the ancient tongue yet, but I have read your notes. You wrote that if Ignominot is resurrected, we can make a world free of demons.
7 years ago, a soul with strong resonance, my own unborn son, was sacrificed for that purpose. Now, Ignominot's resurrections have complete.
Because of that, everyone's resonance has grown stronger, enabling them to see demons.
Yes, that's the truth behind the opening.
So, if one more person is sacrificed...
Ignominot's resurrection will be complete, and his power will spur the creation of many new exorcists.
And there is another Scarlet Knight very soon. Arthur, I must ask.
Lafayette.
Can't I be the sacrifice?
Tell me, why do you think that birds fly?
I think that birds fly because they must. Why else would they have wings if not to embrace the sky? I have wings too. Weak as they are. That's why I must fly. Now!
He doesn't even know.
If we miss this Scarlet Night, the next won't be for another 3 years. By then, I won't be alive.
Lafayette, why would you say such a thing?
He knows about the disease?
The 12-year sickness. That's the name of my disease.
So you know.
I'm not afraid of being sick. But I don't want to just be a burden on everyone until I die. I couldn't take it.
Your wings are your will. And they are strong.
Lars. Please. You can't tell Velvet about this.
I promise.
I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Yeah. That's gonna break something.
Don't talk to me about Will! About Wings! Both of you! Together! You betrayed me!
Oh no.
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right? Hurry back. I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him.
Shut up!
He fell further than this back at the shrine. I will have my revenge.
Revenge for Lafayette!
Lafayette knew so much more pain than I ever will. And still, I couldn't do anything for him. I'm sorry.
Shut up! It's a lie! A dirty lie! All of it! It's all their lies! And I believed it! Die! 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 Die!
Hello, something. I don't know what that is.
Get out of my way, you disgusting monster!
Okay, fire.
What is this thing?
An amalgamation of multiple demons?
It doesn't matter seven. What it is.
Should
I'll
be fine.
Devour it until it's dead. Shooting star. Storm dragon. Separate weight.
Fertile blue.
Oh, that thing. That'll be difficult to dodge. Okay, just using my fire combo, slowly bringing him down. He can attack a lot of different directions, and that's his main strength at the moment, it seems. At least, he's not in desperation mode yet, at the very least. Oh, what is that? Clouds of something.
Hold the arch of my ancestors! Ungifted
style! Aaron! Okay, just a little bit more. Yeah, it doesn't seem like it has much of a desperation stage at the moment. No, that wasn't one of the more difficult bosses. An illusion. It's an illusion. It has to be.
Is that... I'm dead.
Calm down, Velvet. This farce is just another of Venominat's illusions.
Would it make sense if it was real?
Farce? How callous. That farce is the true face of my sister. She hates... resents, devours, and kills. She tramples people, cities, everything, living only by her emotions. What an ugly, tainted soul.
It's not like that!
Nothing you say will matter. She knows. She knows if it's the truth. He's right. Just think, everything I did was baseless, arrogant. And even so, I still... You hurt so many innocent people, didn't you? More than I can count. I devoured and killed so many. Without even knowing Arthur's true aims. I destroyed people. Destroyed whole towns. And worse yet, you didn't even show mercy to your own sister's reincarnation. I hate her. And despite all of that, I still love you, Velvet. That's why
I chose to become a sacrifice. For you, sister.
This isn't Laffy.
But think, if you try to stop the resurrection, wouldn't my death be all for nothing?
Even if it's a resurrection as a Moloch.
To tell you the truth, I was terrified of dying. It was so dark.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You'll accept it then? That everything you've done up until this point, all of it.
Yes.
No.
It was all for nothing, and for no one.
No.
I hurt so many people, all for no reason. I'm a monster.
If you've accepted it, you have to atone for your sins. Once I eat the final two malevolences inside you, I'll fully awaken. Give them to me. Give me your hatred, your despair. If you do, I can cleanse this world of all its pain. I had hoped that you could live in a world without pain and sadness. But you're a monster now. You don't belong there.
Whatever that's supposed to be. That's not really supposed to be one of them.
We have to go.
No.
No! If you don't, you'll die too for no reason.
No!
A twisted monster like me doesn't deserve to live. Don't you understand?
You're the reincarnation of the first sacrifice. Part of me. Don't worry. I'll devour you, too.
Laffy Set, tell this self-absorbed idiot what she needs to hear!
Please, let me go.
Will you stop whining?! Huh? No, I don't understand!
You snap at people! You're scary! You
tried to eat me! But... you're also kind, and you're filled with life. I don't understand a single thing about you, but you gave me a name when I was a number. You gave me that compass. You taught me what it meant to be alive. That's why I care about you, Velvet. I'll protect you for my own sake. I don't care if you're malevolent, or if it was pointless! If the world says it's a mistake to love you, I'll fight the whole world! I don't care how much pain you feel! It doesn't matter! A world without you, Velvet! Is the one thing I couldn't bear!
Let me go. My hand will... I loved them all. I loved Laffy and Celica, Arthur, everyone. To have it all stolen from me. Why them? Why not me? It hurts so much!
Your despair, how is it gone?
A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet.
Ares.
I finally understand how you felt. But the only one I can fight for is myself. That's good enough. That's proof that you are truly alive.
How many times do you plan to destroy and rebuild your own heart, Moggy Lou?
We're on 107. Who was it, 108? I lost count. Not that I really care.
Pathetic fool. Did I not tell you it would require an iron will as indomitable as the very trees that live and die across millennia?
Like you, I suppose. Or that boy over there?
That is the foundation of an ideal world. One free from man's sins.
Ideal my ass.
An ideal world, huh? You, kid. The boy who was your companion, Lafayette. He's alive. Chasing a terrifying demon girl, he has learned the immensity of the seas and weathered the dry wastes of the land. Those people, they're different from us. Despite the pain, the anguish, they embrace the life they've been given. They live, undaunted by the ugliness of the world!
So you're doing this all for them? Is that what this is?
Not even close. They aggravate me to my wit's end. Like stabs in the chest, over and over and over. And that's exactly why.
Makes you feel alive?
That's why. I intend to see how all of this ends. I won't be satisfied until I do.
Words bereft of meaning. You truly are my greatest failure.
Gosh, funny just how little I care. No! Please!
And perfect timing. Oh, Ice and Swag was amazing there.
Let me guess. We came at a good time?
You're late. Because of you, I had to have a really boring conversation.
So, you came face to face with Innominat. If so, then you must know that your quest for revenge is utterly meaningless.
Yeah, I did. I know why sadness fills the world, and I know how deep are the burdens of sin. I tried to abandon my memories of Arthur and Laffy, to cut myself off from it all. And end this tragedy. It's what they would have wanted.
Exactly. You do well to know your place.
But that's exactly why I can't forgive them. Not Artorias, not Innominat. I know my heart is ugly and full of contradictions, but those days we spent together in familial warmth, they're proof that all of us were truly alive. That's why, no matter how hard, no matter how sad it gets, I will take my vengeance to the very end.
Velvet!
Don't be a fool. Just give up and die like you ought. It is your destiny to wallow in despair.
You take my family, turn me into a monster, and you want my soul too. Now who's being the fool?
Is he gonna run away?
Remember this well. The Lord of Calamity never gives up, not even in the face of death.
Have you no shame for your sins? You unholy monster!
Let me in on this. I lost a bet, and I've got some anger to work out.
You sure you can fight in your condition?
Who do you think I am? Ooh, I thought you'd never ask. I am the dastardly witch Mogilu, scourge of self-righteous exorcists! Now face the wrath of Mogilu Maven!
Fools, all of you!
Yes! Fuck him. Yes, I will destroy him. Shame I don't really have any.
Everyone, sorry to have worried you.
I wasn't worried.
Oh, he is going to be hard to...
Someone who needed looking after. Me neither.
This is our way of saying we trust you.
Yeah. You horrible ingrate!
See?
Stabbed in the chest, that's all you give me. One way!
Man, 24. Okay. This is manageable. You guys focus on Milk here. Focus on this fuck. Just need to knock him out of all his Malik arts. And you guys can take care of Milk here, fine. Oh, this is not difficult at the moment. Let's see if Milk here pulls out something super strong later down the line. Ooh, okay, so definitely get a Pinocchio out there. Gro, you look very free at the moment. Ooh, okay. He has a knockback going on there. Put them in coordination, that might be a bit more dangerous, but at the moment it seems very manageable. Fee, you look available. Gotta keep my health up if I'm stunned. I don't think I can direct them to go after specific people. This is unfortunate. I could coordinate this much better if I can make them focus on Melkier more. Okay, how much left? Not much. And... there we go. Okay, with that in mind, I definitely want you to switch out for her. Not because I want to use her, but because, hopefully she'll be able to use her Spellbreaker ability to keep him from using any Malik arts. Not that I think he's particularly capable of doing that at the moment. And I probably don't want anyone else but Velvet coming in and attacking anyways. So it's probably good to have everyone else as distance runners, in a sense. What is he actually weak to? I haven't checked. Okay. So I should be trying to use that combo more. Okay. 20,000 left. Okay. Very manageable at the moment. Okay. Doggy Doo's out of her thing, so... won't be able to stop him from using them if I don't knock him out myself.
No mercy! You thought I'd stop there? Annihilating?
Oh, 30,000. Yes.
Ugh.
If I had chained that one, man, that would have been a great situation.
They took something precious from me. I'll never forgive them for that.
The annals of history are stained with evil people like you.
Yeah, you're not that much better.
You spread havoc and destruction all to satisfy your own ends. A dark font of malevolence. You're a demon lord. The irredeemable embodiment of sin.
Blah.
Lord of calamity.
It is blah. The exorcist's duty blah, blah, to destroy blah, you.
Blah.
You talk a lot. How about you keep talking and tell us where Ifrit is?
You'll regret this.
I can feel Enominat. He's coming!
We can fight here no longer.
Bianfu, close the rift!
I can't!
Come forth!
Oh, hello. Okay, what are you doing here?
Carelessness will get you killed.
Zavid!
You ruined the moment.
Indeed.
Huh? Don't you mean, thanks for saving us, Zavid? You're my hero and role model.
Thank you for saving us, Zavid.
Where exactly are we now?
We're in an abbey facility on Hexen Isle. I heard Melchior was in charge here, so I snuck in. I hadn't expected an extra-dimensional space.
Is there a way out?
There is now that I busted my way in.
Let's head outside. We can talk then.
We shouldn't leave him.
Who's that?
A friend. His name is Number One.
Hey, wanna come with us?
They similar hair colors.
If you stay here alone, a dragon might get you. I bet you wouldn't like that.
Yeah, that sounds scary.
Ooh.
Great. Come on, kid.
Emotions.
What are you doing?
We can't leave him like this. I'll get him a vessel, somehow.
Do what you like.
Well, we still have Eleanor. We can give it to her and stuff and like that and that stuff. Anyway. Okay, well, that explains a lot. That was gratifying. That was very, very gratifying at the very least. Are we going to go destroy the world out of selfishness? Maybe. But honestly, looking at everyone here, everyone's a fucking bad guy, except maybe Eleanor. She's just cooperating with the bad guys. So this is really just everyone else. Wants their own solution for how people should live, and they're all doing horrible things to try to achieve it, basically, and it's going to end badly no matter what, right? That's what it feels like it's going towards, so. I definitely recorded a bit long today. Well, whatever. Long episode. Especially since this is a bit of a transition week into new schedule. Oh, yeah, and again, these are going to be posted in weird times in the near future. Well, not weird times. It's going to have a new schedule, consistent schedule, starting next week. Because I'm going to be doing at most one video a day and alternating between three or two series, depending on how many I have going at a time. It's going to be more manageable for me, so. This is still going to have probably the same amount, just on different days at different times. So I'll probably post in the comments when I decide precisely what I want to do for that. I'll see you all next time, then. That's all I got. Drive safely, everyone.